Outside Coolgardie, Western Australia, the Bates family gold mine legacy is on the brink of bankruptcy, leaving the mine SOS team 6 days to haul their operation back into profit.
So we've come up with a plan.
Okay.
First of all, we want to try and find you some decent ground.
Great.
You've got a massive lease here. So, the potential here is huge. So hopefully Aaron's going to be able to pinpoint some good locations for you. The other thing we want to do is also do some sampling on the dirt you've already pushed aside. There potentially should be some fine gold in there as well, and little nuggets that you couldn't pick up with your detector.
Wow.
So one of the ways to recover fine gold and process a couple of tonnes a day is to build you guys a bulk sampling wet sluice.
I know you don't have much water here, so I'm going to have to run it off the back of the truck with some water pods.
Wow.
We want to take you from the 2 grams a week to at least 10. We'd like to ask that anything over 10 grams, we basically get a percentage just to cover our costs.
Sounds more than fair. Mm. Hey, if we get a win, we all get a win.
That's it. That's what we're here for. Happy to do it.
Yes.
Thanks, bud.
Cheers, mate.
Yeah, we've pretty much stripped everything off it now that we're not going to keep. Now it's just about getting rid of the surface rust and then we'll give it a quick prime. I don't have time to sandblast it, unfortunately, but it'll still come up looking like $1 million.
I'm just welding up the crank. Then I'm going to go around and find spots that need welding.
Okay, this is looking really, really good.
We've been able to take the readings off those samples. We've got 4 good stockpiles. One of the stockpiles was made from an area where they found 20 ounces of gold, and that's showing that definitely looks like there's a lot more gold in it. The good thing that's come up, there's 2 or 3 additional stockpiles that we sampled that are also showing that there's some potential there for processing the dirt. It's nice to bring some positive news back. Let's hope that we can get some gold out of this dirt.
Well, it doesn't look pretty, but it's ready for painting.
Yeah. It'll come up nice.
Once it's dry, we can give it a quick paint job. Then we'll put the sluice on, load it back on the truck and get her out of here.
Can't wait to get the sluice on.
We've got so much to do at the moment. Just asking the old man to come in here and give us a hand with that sluice, because yeah, we're really running out of time. We've only got a few hours left to get this build finished.
Paul's dad, John, has worked in the gold mining industry for over 30 years.
Now, the guys out there don't have a water source on their lease, so as it is, I'm going to have to truck in about 4,000 litres on the back of the truck just to do our testing. And I'll run through that pretty quick if they're wasting water. So by reducing the size of the sluice, we're going to be able to make the water last a lot longer. If we make the water last a lot longer, we're going to be able to process more material and capture more gold.
Paul, I'm going to start priming this because we're actually running out of time. We're going to be out of here soon.
Yeah, go for it. I'm busy here with the electrical stuff. Make sure she fits in there.
A bit of a push. That's it. Yep. There you go. Lovely.
Well done.
Just like I bought one.
That's perfect.
Yeah, it's in. You just need to get the angle right now and then we can put some uprights on the bottom to hold it into position. I'm getting a bit more excited now. Let's finish her off. I am confident we're going to get everything finished tonight, but it just means a few extra hours.
I'm excited to take it out to the Bates. I think they're going to be stoked to see it.
Still got some work to do with it, but you know, we'll be here a bit longer, but it's good to know we're going to actually have something to take out there to test this soil, because we really want to test these new areas that are going to have some great gold potential. So looking forward to getting back there.
Hopefully, fingers crossed, touch wood, we can get out there tomorrow.
I've still got to finish off the flooring, but if you need me for anything, because this is pretty important, just yell out and I can come over. And...
yeah, we'll do. We're just going to plug it all in, do a test run with the water.
Perfect.
And then we can get the loader over here and put some dirt through and start making some gold. We really want to help these guys out, and I don't want to fail them. We want to get them more gold. We want to put them back on the road to recovery from where they are currently, which is financial ruin.
The Bates family gold mine had been capturing just 2 grams of gold a week, worth $160. It barely covered costs and left them with no income. To stay in business, today's test must produce 5 times as much gold and hit the 10 gram, $800 a week survival target.
Yeah, so this dirt here is the dirt that they've grabbed from around where they've got all the nuggets. So hopefully there's a bit of fine gold in there. I'll fire it up now, mate.
Water comes down here, and we're catching all the gold in the mats here.
This is awesome.
Fantastic, isn't it?
Finally feels like we can actually be productive again now.
Leaning down that way.
See, it's just there a little bit. It's not flowing like the other side.
Yeah.
So it means that it's on an angle, so it needs to come up a little bit on this side, or it's something up here that you need to fix.
The custom-made wet plant doesn't come with a user manual, giving Tim, Steve and Julie a steep learning curve.
Going all right down there?
Yeah, it is. That's really good. But it's even. We can only do so much today because we've only got a certain amount of water, but this will be a perfect test to see how much gold we can get out of here.
Sprays are stopped. Out of water.
Do you want me to open that other pot?
Yeah.
With just 6 1,000-litre water pots to fuel the test run, every last drop is crucial to the trio's survival.
I hope there's gold in this dirt. There's a lot of big rocks in it, though, like that. So I've got to be up here to help wash it all through because it's just clogging up the stream. Got to do it as quick as we can while we got the water.
Yeah.
Yep. Just about out of water anyway, so get this one through and that'll be it for the day, eh?
Cool.
There it is. Nice clean water at the end.
After 3 hours, the team have successfully processed 2.5 tonnes of dirt using the new plant.
Well, we ready to do this, eh?
Yep.
Well, let's get it in there.
The final step is to clean the sluice mats and pan through the remnants for signs of gold.
One yellow.
Wow.
Have you got gold?
Yeah.
Can't see anything at the moment.
Ready?
Oh, I see. Oh. You bloody beauty.
Oh, my. Have a look at this. At first, I couldn't see it, and I lifted my head, and the sun just hit it, and I was like, yeah. Oh.
That's excellent. That's good. For what we put through, that is exactly what you wanted to see.
That's unreal. That was a lot more than I thought that we were getting. I thought there was just going to be like a couple of little dots here and there.
Yeah.
When we first got here, you guys were telling us that you're only pulling in 2 grams a week.
Mm.
And you can't live off that. We asked you what kind of gold you would like to see.
10 grams we can work with.
Yep. All right, you ready?
Four and a half.
Four and a half, that's not bad.
What we're getting before. Yeah. That's nice.
Double the weekly intake. I want to know what come across the sluice.
That's our bread and butter.
And what do we need? 5.5.
5.5.
Yep.
Fingers crossed.
Here we go.
If these guys are going to have a sustainable future, they need to be getting gold out of the soil as well. So, it kind of all comes down to this, to be honest.
Well, let's see if the sluice did it.
Yeah.
Seven, nine. Oh.
You get it?
Yep.
10.2.
Oh. You're beautiful.
Well, we made it.
Thank you. Awesome job, mate. Thank you.
Oh, look, it was, to be honest, beyond my expectations. That's just a fantastic result.
Thank you.
That's amazing.
I didn't think that was in there, to be honest.
No, I didn't either.
I'm ecstatic. I didn't get much sleep last night because I was too worried and concerned about what this outcome was going to be today, but I'm going to sleep well tonight.